Okay, hello, hello. Okay, welcome to your language class. Hola, chicos. Okay. Bien, vamos a nuestra clase de language. Okay, open your book on page 114. Abrimos página 114. Okay, excellent. 114. Okay. So, are you ready? Yes? Okay, you have contractions here. We continue studying contractions. Yes, and learning contractions. Vamos a seguir aprendiendo contracciones. Okay, so let's see, contraction. What is a contraction? Do you remember what is a contraction? Okay, let me show you. Okay, but in English, a contraction is formed by combining two words. An apostrophe is used to show where letters are being left out. Okay, una contracción se forma de dos palabras y se le agrega una apóstrofe. Okay, para mostrar que es una contracción. Yes?
Example, do not the word and create.
Okay. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so let's see. This one is on page 114. And we have, for example, we have is and have. Yes? So we write apostrophe S and apostrophe VE. Yeah, we say he is, his. It is, its. She is, she's. That is, that's. I have, I've. They have, they've. We have, we've. And you have, you. Yes, so this one are the different contraction that we studied today. So let's repeat. He is, his. It is, it's. She is, she's. That is, that's. I have, I've. They have, they've. We have, we've. You have, you've. Yeah? Okay. He is, his. It is, it's. She is, she's. That is, that's. I have, I've. They have, they've. We have, we've. You have, you've. Yeah? Okay. So let's see. Now, you write the contraction for it. Each set of words below. So we write here from 1 to N. So let's see. Now you write the contractions. I give you 5 minutes and then we check the answers. Yes? Okay, so let's solve exercise A. I have, so you write here the contraction. Yes? I give you 5 minutes and then we check. So you do this exercise by yourself. Lo va a hacer por usted mismo. Luego vamos a chequear respuesta, ¿ya? Okay, so you need to use the charts that you have above. Okay, puede usar los cuadros que tiene en la parte de arriba. Okay, let's do it. Okay, excellent. I see you. You are working. Okay, so let's see, 5 minutes. It's missing 4. Okay, when you finish, so you put a heart as a reaction. Yeah? Cuando termine, me pone su corazoncito como reacción. Mm-hmm. Okay, Lucas, excellent. Okay, Mario. Okay, Paulette. Okay, who else? Remember, when the class finished, you send the evidence of these exercises, yeah? termina su clase de language y usted me envía las evidencias. Sí, no se le olvide enviar esas páginas de language. Las trabajamos juntos, pero usted tiene que enviarme evidencia para así yo ver de que usted las ha hecho junto conmigo. Okay, so let's see. Let's start. Okay, I have. What is the contraction? I. Yes, I have. I. They have. Dave. Okay. Remember, you need to write the correct in the correct place apostrophe. Tienen que escribir en el lugar correcto la apóstrofe. Eso es muy importante. You have. You've. We have. We've. It is. It's. That is. That's. She is. She's. And he is. His. Yes? Okay. Excellent. I have. I. They have. They. You have. You. We have. We. It is. It's. That is. That's. She is. She's. He is. His. Yes, this one is our son. Esta es la canción de nuestras contracciones. Okay, así la vamos a cantar. Okay, let's sing right now. I have, I, they have, they, you have, you, we have, we, it is, it's, that is, that's, she is, she's, he is, his. Yes, okay, one more time. And now you help me, let me check. Okay, Aaron, Allison, Mateo Salmerón, you help me, okay? You three. Ustedes tres me van a ayudar a cantar la canción, yes? Okay, Aaron, Alison, and Mateo Salmerón. Okay, let's count. One, two, three, action. I have,
I have, I. They have, they. You have, you. We have, we. It is, the, it's, that is, that. She is, she's, he is, his.
Okay. Okay, excellent. So let's see, Mateo Salmerón, it's your turn. Okay, es su turno. Okay, so let's see.
Canción, ¿a dónde?
Okay, so let's see. This one is our song. Remember when you practice, let me see, the vowel song. ¿Se recuerda cuando practicaba en kinder, la canción de las vocales? O de sí, las consonantes. Sí. Ok, capital M, little M. M says, hace milk. M says, ok, it's similar to this one.
Yeah?
Ok, so let's see, similar to that. Ok, at the end of the class, we'll practice one more time. Ok, now, exercise B. Complete each sentence by writing the contraction for the words in parentheses. Okay, so you have the two words in parentheses and you write the correct form of the correct contractions. I have been reading about some strange animals at the zoo. What is the contraction? Let's check. Okay, Alejandro Mendoza, what is the contraction?
I have, I've
been reading, yes? Okay, excellent. Number two, I think it is a fun thing to do. Okay, in that part, Mateo Estrada, what is the correct contraction in number two?
Hello, miss.
Hi.
It's.
Okay, I think it's, exactly. Okay.
It's a fun thing to do.
Excellent. Okay. Let's see, let's continue. Okay, Jose Oliva. Number three, that is the book I have been reading. What is the contraction in that case? In number three, that is. Okay, Jose Oliva, what is the correct contraction?
Good morning.
Morning. Okay.
That.
Okay, that's exactly. That is, that's the book. Excellent. Okay, next one. Let's check. Okay, Mario, number four, David said, He is going to make a poster of an interesting animal. Okay, Mario, what is the contraction in that case?
His.
Okay, excellent. David said his. Okay, that's good. Mateo Castellón, the last one, number five. Mrs. Keen said she is going to let David display his poster in the hall. What is the contraction of she is, Mateo Castellón? Okay. Creo que tenemos que chequear sonido, Mateo. Sí, porque lo tiene activado, pero no lo logramos escuchar. Ok. Luego yo le doy la participación. No se preocupe. Ok, vamos a ver. Aaron, what is the contraction in number five?
Good morning, miss.
Morning.
She's.
Ok, Mrs. King said she's going. Exactly. Ok, she's going. That's good. Okay, next exercise. Write a sentence using the contraction. Okay, interrogative, in that case, you. Remember, this one is the contraction of you have. Yeah? Okay, an interrogative sentence. And in number two, exclamatory sentence using the contraction that. Yeah? Okay, for example, an interrogative sentence in that case. Let me see.
You have a big toy of marble.
Okay, did you have a big toy of marble? Yes, that's good. Okay. Did you have a green book? Did you have a big green book? Yeah, this is another one. Okay. So let's see. Let me write here the sentence of Mateo. Did
no, you a comic of marble?
Ah, okay. Okay, did you have a comic of marble? Yes, this is a question. Okay, now exclamatory sentence using that. Okay, that's my bowl. Tell me, Ariana.
That's a great movie.
Okay, that's a great movie. Yeah. Okay, that's a great movie. That's a great movie. Yes. Okay, that's my bowl. That's a great movie. Okay, excellent examples.
That's my Funko Pop of.
Ah, okay. That's my Funko of.
Of John Wick.
Ah, okay, of John Wick. Okay, excellent. That's good. Okay. That's a snake. Yeah, this is another one. Excellent, Alisa. That's a snake. Okay. So let's see. We finished page 114. Now we pass to page 115. Okay, we continue diagramming. Okay, remember, in the last period, we diagramming subject and verb. Yeah. Okay, now we continue doing this part. Yes? Okay, I erase. I'm sorry. Then I give you the answers, yes? Okay. Remember, mark each sentence diagramming the subject in the verb. Okay, we have the sentences here. Ethan is kicking the soccer ball. Okay, who is the subject? Ethan, yes. Okay, Ethan is the subject. And the verb, what that's mean? What is the action?
Kicking.
What is the action in that sentence? Ethan is kicking the soccer ball.
Kicking.
Is kicking. Okay. Remember, in that case, we use a helping word or a helping verb. Okay. Estamos usando verbos de ayuda. Y decíamos que el verbo siempre va a incluir el verbo, the helping verb, and the action verb. Yes? Okay. Number two, Henry has eaten his dinner. Okay, the subject. Who is the subject in that sentence?
Henry.
Okay, Henry. And what is the action? Okay. Has only has eaten. Yes, okay, has eaten, exactly. Okay, let me check. Adrian, in number three, who is the subject in the sentence number three?
Cut.
Okay, Adrian, who is the subject? Okay, Daniela Blandón, who is the subject in that sentence?
La idea en plural.
Okay, so let's see. In that case, the subject is cat. Yeah, and poor is the verb. Yeah, that's mean the action. Cat poor. Okay. Okay, excellent. In number four, Molly is my good friend. Okay, Paulette, who is the subject in that sentence?
Molly.
Okay. And the action or the verb?
Is.
Okay. Molly is. Yes. Okay. Lucas, in number five, owls and parrots live at the zoo. In that case, we have two subjects. What is the subject number one?
Owls.
Okay. And subject number two?
Parrot.
Okay. And the action?
Live.
Okay, excellent. Okay, owls, parrots, and leave. Yeah. Okay, I give you 2 minutes for completing this part. Yeah. When you finish, you put the reaction. Yes. That means you finish. Okay, thank you, Matias. Okay, thank you, Mateo. Okay, Magali. Okay, Jose Oliva. Okay, Christopher. Okay. So let's see. In exercise B, if you finish, draw a line between the subject and the predicate. That's mean the verb. And we underline the verb in verb phrases 2 times and underline the subject 1 time. Yes. Okay. First one, we identify in that case. Okay. I show you. Yes. Garden eels are a strange kind of fish. in that case, okay, garden eels, this one is the subject. So you underline one time, yeah? Okay, and are a strange kind of fish. We have the action, and in that case, the action is are. For that reason, we underline two times, yes? And remember, we divide subject and predicate with a vertical line. Okay, you can use your colors in that part. Next one, in number two, you can see them at the Basel Zoo. Okay, so we separate subject and predicate. Yes, we underline the subject one time. And we underline the verb two times. Yes? Excellent. Okay, number three. They look like small worms. So we separate subject and predicate. Underline the subject one time. And we underline the verb or the action two times. That in that case is look. Yes? Okay. Number four, they have no fins. Okay, you know what is the meaning of fins? Okay. Fins, espinas. Yes, okay. So let's see. We underline the subject one time, they, and the verb two times, and in that case is have. Yeah. Okay. Number five, the eel digs a tube-shaped hole in the sand. So we separate the subject, in that case it's eel, in the verb or the action, we underline two times, but in that case it's dig, yeah. In number six, they slide up and down the tube. Okay, we separate the subject, but in that case it's they, in the verb, we underline two times, that is a slide. Yes, a slide. Okay, this is strange fish. So we separate the subject is fish. Ah, but check this sentence. In that sentence, we have two action verbs. The first verb is sit, and the second verb is wait. Yes? So we have two verbs in that sentence. That means this one is a compound predicate. Okay, excellent. So I give you some minutes. Yes? Okay, recuerde que cuando separamos, lo hacemos por colores, ¿verdad? Cuando separamos de manera vertical, utilizamos verde. Cuando subrayamos sujeto, lo hacemos rojo. Y cuando subrayamos verbo, lo hacemos azul dos veces. Yes? Okay.
Miss.
Tell me.
Me olvidó que teníamos que hacerlo con cola. Lo voy a tener que repetir.
Ok, lo va a tener que hacer de nuevo. Ok, that's good. Ok, excellent. So let's wait 2 minutes, yeah? And then we continue. Vamos a esperar 2 minutos a los compañeros y luego continuamos. Ok. Imagine, we almost finished the class day. Casi terminamos el día de clases ahora. Ok, ya mañana es miércoles, mitad de la semana. Siento que ya vamos a decir, mañana es Navidad. Va muy rápido el tiempo. Sí.
Mañana es día de niño.
Ah,
sí, la verdad, es cierto, Miss.
Okay.
Ah, me olvidé.
Es que sea vacación.
Ah,
ya se fue el invierno.
domingo.
Sí, sabe que el domingo fue el día del niño en Argentina.
Yes, I saw different pictures about this one. Also Venezuela, I think.
¿Y cuándo va a ser el día del niño?
El 1 de octubre.
Falta mucho, mucho, mucho.
Miren,
no, solo como un día es 1 de octubre y yo cumplo el 20 de octubre.
Un año. Día, digamos. Un mes, un día.
Doble regalo va a tener entonces.
Ajá, doble regalo.
Ok. Mi hermanita cumple el 10. Y sabe que primero de octubre. Oh, primero de octubre cae viernes.
Miss. Vamos a tener triple vacación, Miss.
Va a tener clase. Ok, tell me.
Mi cumpleaños cae el mejor día. Porque
¿cuándo?
Yo cumplo el 2 de noviembre.
Ah, ok. Excelente, muy bien. Sí, porque tiene día festivo. Ok, let's see. Let's continue. Ok, page 116. Ok, we have contractions here. Is, isn't. Ok, that's mean. Negative and positive. Use is and isn't with a singular subject. Gideon is my new friend. Okay. My friend isn't in my class at school. Yes. Is and isn't. Check this one. Singular subject. Sujeto singular. That's mean when you talk about only one. Yes. Use are and aren't with a plural subject. The boys are at the baseball game. Alex and Henry aren't at home. Okay, that's mean when you talk about two or more. Yes? Use are or aren't with the subject you. Are you ready for church yet? You aren't wearing your baseball hat? Yeah? Okay. Is, isn't, singular subject. When you talk about only one. Are, aren't, plural subject when you talk about two or more, but also when the subject, you. Okay, con el pronombre you, usted va a usar are or aren't. Yes? Okay, so let's see. Let's continue with this part. Okay, we complete each sentence, okay, by using is, isn't, are, or aren't. Okay, number one, trains. Okay, trains. This one is singular or is plural? What do you think? Trains. Singular or plural? We say only one, two or more. Trains. Let me see. What do you think? Okay, Allison, trains. This one is singular or is plural?
Plural.
Plural. So that's mean we use are, yes, trains are fun to ride to the zoo. Yeah, because we talk about two or more trains. Recuerde, cuando un nombre tiene una S al final es porque estamos hablando en plural. Yeah, okay, number two. Today, the day we go to the zoo. Okay, in that case, what do you think is the best option? I show you this one. Is today the day we go to the zoo? ¿Es ahora el día en que vamos a ir al cine? Isn't today, ¿no es hoy el día en que vamos a ir al cine? Okay, so we mention only one. When we say today, that day, day is only one. For that reason, we use is or isn't. Yes? Okay. Es como cuando ustedes se preguntan en negativo. ¿No era hora que íbamos a ir al cine? Yeah, this one is in negative. It's not today the day we go to the zoo. Yeah? Okay. So let's see. Number three. Tomorrow going to be a warm day. Okay. Tomorrow, warm day. We talk about one, two or more. Okay. In that case, we say day. This is only one. So that's mean this one is? Singular, yes? Okay, so we say is or isn't. Tomorrow is going to be a warm day. Mañana será un día muy caliente, okay? Let's see. Now, number four, the elephant's hum. Very large.
Las dos, en, así que están, no sé cómo. Una...
cosita.
Ah, yes.
Las dos.
Ok. No. Podemos escribir las dos. Quiere decir que podemos decirlo en positivo o en negativo. Yes. Ok. The elephant's hum. Ok. In that case, is, are, isn't, or aren't. What do you think? Allison.
Are.
Ok. So let's see. This one is a possessive. The elephant's hum. La casa de los elefantes. So we talk about only one, yeah?
More than,
Yes, okay, you say the elephant's home. ¿De quién estamos hablando? Okay, ¿de los elefantes o de la casa?
The elephant's home is the
okay, the elephant's home. Estamos hablando de la casa, okay? ¿A quién le pertenece la casa? A los elefantes. Okay, so this one is possessive. Yeah, the elephant's home is very large. Okay, so let's see. Number five, the penguins, singular or plural?
Plural.
Plural. That's mean. The penguins are walking through the zoo. Yes, penguins. So we have an S at the end of the noun. So this one is plural. Penguins are. Okay, the giraffe. One or two, singular or plural? The giraffe. Singular. Okay, the giraffe is very tall. We talk about only one.
One.
Okay, number seven. Those lemurs. Fun to watch. Okay, plural.
Plural.
So they are, exactly. Okay, those lemurs are fun to watch. Flamingos.
Plural.
Okay, flamingos are pretty pink birds. Okay, plural, yes. Flamingos are pretty pink birds. Number nine, our teacher. Allison, you raise your hand.
Yes.
Okay, our teacher is helping us find many different animals, exactly. Okay, number 10, the garfish and seahorses interesting, singular or plural?
A plural.
Okay, we have two subjects. The first one is garfish. And the second one is seahorses. So that's me. We talk about
plural.
So we say are the garfish and seahorse interesting? Okay. Are garfish and seahorses? So we have two subjects. In that case, it's plural. You tired after working all day? Okay, remember the rule.
Are.
If you have you, okay, you use are or aren't. Are you tired? ¿Estás tú cansado? Aren't you tired? ¿No estás cansado? Yes. Okay. So let's see, I give you 2 minutes, yes, for completing this part.
I finish.
I finish.
Okay. Okay, so let's see in the last one, if you finish this part. Underline the correct word in parentheses twice. Okay, so you have in parentheses is or are, so you choose one of two. Okay. Spider monkeys is are at the Basel Zoo. What do you think? Then I show you the answer. Okay. You say number one is are. Number two, the monkey is are an acrobat. Is or are? Okay. You say are. Okay. Number three. This monkeys is are able to swim from branch to branch. Is are.
¿Cuál era la segunda?
Okay, wait. usted me, no, usted me está dando la respuesta. Después vamos a ver si cuál es. Ok. These monkeys is are able to swim from branch to branch. What do you think? Is or are?
Are.
Okay, you say are. Number four, their long fingers is are what help them grip the branches.
Is.
Is. Okay. The gorilla is are an animal that I like to watch.
Are.
Okay, is. So you tell me. Number one, are. Number two, is, are. Is, number is. Three, are. Number four is, and number five are. So this one to say. Okay, now let's check the answers. Okay, yes, spider monkeys are in that case. Yes, because it's going to be plural. The monkey is, because we talk about only one. These monkeys are. So we talk about two or more monkeys. Number four, their long fingers, okay, dedos. This one is in plural. So this one is are. And the gorilla is miss. Or are? Is, exactly. The gorilla is.
Miss, yo no circulé.
Okay, that's good. But remember, we underline the verbs two times. Pero recuerde que siempre subrayamos verbos dos veces. Yes? Mm-hmm. Okay, excellent. Ok, evidencias que me va a enviar ahora. ¿Cuáles evidencias me va a enviar ahora? Language. Ok, solo language.
Spelling. Anda las páginas que trae.
Ok, si ya hizo spelling, entonces me lo puede mandar. ¿Cuáles páginas me va a enviar de language? 114. 12, 13,
14,
114, 115 y 116. Exacto, tres páginas. Enciérrelas en un círculo para que me las mande. 114, 115, 116. Ok. Excelente. Muy bien. Bravo, bravo, bravo. Ok, vamos a cantar una canción que cantamos en el kinder. De que lo hicimos muy bien al día de ahora. A la cuenta de 3. 1, 2, 3. Bravo, bravo, bravo.
Bravo, bravo, bravo. Bravísimo, bravo.
Bravo, bravo. Lo hiciste muy bien. Okay. Okay. Excelente, chicos. Pero no puedo hacer sonido de cuates. Ok, muy bien, chicos. Ok. Vamos a ver. Guardamos silencio. Ok, guardamos silencio. ¿Hay alguien que me quiere decir algo? Ok, guardamos silencio. Hay un compañerito que me quiere decir algo y no lo escucho. Ok, gracias por los que están guardando silencio. Vamos a ver. Alejandro Romero, apague su micrófono, por favor. Ok, gracias. Muy bien, vamos a ver. Alejandro Mendoza, ¿tenía algo que decirme? No, ok, perfecto. Muy bien, chicos. Buen provecho. Le felicito por el trabajo de ahora. Recuerde, cada día tenemos que dar el 100%, si no es que más, en cada una de nuestras actividades. ¿De acuerdo? Ok, muy bien. Excelente. Nos vemos el día de mañana, chicos. Feliz provecho. Bendiciones. Cuídense mucho. Sí, y les envío un abrazo. Ok, bye, bye.
Adiós.
Buen provecho.
Gracias, igual.